Today we're going to be talking about the basic makeup of a roll feed. Looking at this drawing on the board, we'll go over a couple of pieces, kind of explain what they do, and get you ready for the next video. Starting off, we're going to talk about the roll feed head. The roll feed head sits behind these guards here, and it bolts up to either a press mount plate or this cabinet. In particular, this has been drawn with a cabinet. This is a 1-4 series feed design. Those are grouped together at Co. And then the five through eight are grouped together. It's as simple as a 4-inch roll is a 4-series feed. An 8-inch roll is an 8-series feed. They have different motor sizes and different drives, but that is as simple as it goes. The next thing we want to talk about is the catenary section. This catenary section has been mentioned on the straightener. Obviously, it's designed very particularly to the different materials that you'll be running. We don't want to put that minimum bend radius. We don't exceed the minimum bend radius to put coil set back in the material, put a bend back in the material. So it's designed very specifically. We have the pinch rolls. They live within this roll feed. They are the driving force behind the roll feed. They do all the work. We have a pilot valve up here, which hits a cylinder and lifts that roll so that we can operate for piloting. We have a optional material support table or oiler, depending on what you purchase. We have a strip lubricator that's optional as well. And then edge guides right here. These are your slide and clamp. Particularly, it's the base model for the 1-4. You simply loosen them up with a lever, move them in position, and then reclamp them down on this particular model. This one is also drawn with an manually adjustable cabinet, and you're able to crank this lever and be able to move the cabinet up and down for pass light adjustment. We also sell a press-mounted feature called the adjustable height bracket, and it does the same thing. It accomplishes the purposes for hitting your different pass line heights. Moving on to the controls cabinet, we are looking at essentially where your drive and the functionality of the machine lives. Because your drive that's here, the only really electronics on this particular piece that are on every single model are your valve and then the servo motor. This carries the servo drive, and it carries your amplifier, it carries your pickups, it has your HMI where you control your feed with, and it has your two buttons, your drive on enable button and then a emergency stop button. And that is the basic componentry of your servo roll feed.